Here, now we are going to study about the sum of subset problem. Sum of subset is here we are having a list of object. In that list of object, we have to select that object so that the total weight is 30. So this is weight for each object. So we have to select that items, then the total weight exactly 30. So here, for that case here, now you see this one, if you are selecting 1, 2, and 5, you will get now 5 plus 10, 15, 15 plus 15, 30. So 30 is one answer. Then another answer is here, we are having that one 5 plus 12 plus 13. So 12 plus 13, 25, 25 plus 5, 30. This is another answer. Then third answer is here, 3 and 6. If you are selecting 3 and 6, then you will get now 30. So that problem is going to be solved. That problem is going to be solved using backtracking. It's going to be solved using backtracking. Please, anyone up answer that audible? Okay, I'll continue now. Okay. Here, now you see this one. Then our algorithm, I am going to convert that our algorithm into flowchart. This is easy for understanding purpose, right? Now you see this one here, sum of subset is a backtracking algorithm. Backtracking algorithm is having that one. First one, we are having starting here sum, initially the sum is zero. Then here we are having, here we have to put k. Sum is zero, k equal to one. And then here remaining is r. So yes, just you change that one, s, k, r. So s, k, r. So sum, the initial object, then this is remaining. So s is here now, initially start with s is 0, k is 1, r is remaining, means then the total object. So this is 0, 1, 73. So this is s, this is k, this is r. So s, k, r. S, k, r is function call, right? So you change that one, s, k, r, right? Next here, what we have to do is, first you have to check that one. S plus W of K equal to M. If equal to M means, then we are attaining that result. So it will print that one result. Attaining one result, it will print that result, right? Initially, we are having X of 1 is 5. So 1 is 5, so X of 1. So we are selecting first object, that 5. So this condition is not satisfied, then it will come to here. So S is initially 0, then 5. So S is initially 0. The five we are having now, right? S is 0, 5. So the total 5 and plus 10. 5 plus 10, 15. 15 is less than or equal to 15. Less than or equal to 30. M is 30. So that the exact weight is 30. So this condition is true. Then it will call. So then it will call once again. So recursive procedure is calling now with here, the second, this node, right? So we are having X equal to 1. And recursive procedure is calling with 5 to 68, right? So 5 to 68 means here, S plus WI is 5, then K plus 1 is 2, right? K is 1, K plus 1 is 2, then the remaining object is initial weight, that R is 73 minus 5, 68. Now we are calling in that place, right? So from that place, now we have to go for, once again, then calling that same place, then it will go for recursive call. So the recursive call is going to take now r equal to 2, so k equal to 2, right? Then here s is already 5, 5 plus 10, 15, 15, 15 equal to m, illa, no. So here it will come to here, so 15 plus 12 plus here we are having 5 plus 10, 15, 15 plus 12, 27. 27 is less than M. The condition is true. Now it will come to here. So we are coming to this branch. So here we are calling. Now once again, we are calling the same function within that one. We are calling the same function with 15, 3, 58. Now S is 15, K is 3, R is 58. Now we are calling that function. now you are calling that function here. Now this condition is not satisfied. How it is? 15 plus 12 plus 13. The 15 plus 12, 27 plus 13. Here we are having 40. 40 is less than m. The condition is not satisfied. Then it will come back, go to B. Then it will come to this location. So here. So this is go to B. Now what will happen here? Here it will check this condition. So S plus R minus WK, right? So you are, if suppose you are avoiding that X3, right? So WK, here we are coming, WK is 3. So if you are avoiding W3, whether it is possible to get an answer or not, right? So R and this S plus WK, so you are avoiding that one. Next object if you are adding, then that should be less than or equal to M. So this condition is satisfied. Now it will go to here. So X of K equal to 0. So we are avoiding that object. And we'll come to here. We are calling with the same old weight. And we are calling with the fourth object. And R minus WK. So here we are having. So 15 as it is. And 3 is K plus 1, 4. Then here remaining is 58 minus 12, 46. Here we are having. This is the place we are calling now. So we are calling now. We are calling now, so it will return back to R2. So here now calling now this function. So this function calling now, then we are checking now. This is also not possible once again. Here how it is actually, we are calling the same function here with that this location. So we are calling that function. So what it will happen here? This condition is not satisfied. Then it will come to here. Then this condition also here, this condition is satisfied. Then it will call with that X of 0 with next object. So we are avoiding fourth object also. Then we are going to have here. So fourth object avoiding 15, then plus 5 plus 33, right? 46 minus 13, 33. Now we are in this position. Now once again we are calling that function with 15, 5, 33, right? So 15, 5, 33. Now we are calling that function 15, 5, 33. Now this condition is satisfied. So 15, the fifth object is 15, 15 plus 15, 30, M. Now it will print. So here this content is printing now. So it will print the sequence, right? So the sequence is x1 is 1, x2 is 1, x3 is 0, x4 is 0, x5 is 1. So your result is 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, the last one also 0, right? So we are selecting the object x1, x2 and x5. So after completing that one, how it will return now? So this is here we are printing now. After printing, now what will happen here? Now it will come to, after printing, then it will come back to here, right? So here it will check that one. So this condition is not satisfied. Then it will go to D. Then once again return. So once again return is return to that R1. Then it will go through that D. Then here it will come. Then it will return to R2. Return to R2 means here this return will go to R2. Then once again it will go to return. So go to return. Then go to return. So here what it will happen here. We are coming through that D. We'll come to return. Then it will return intent to return here, intent to return here. Now from that one, we are returning here, it will return to R1. So in that R1 here we are having now. Now what will happen here? We are in the position. So we are using this value. Now we are checking this condition. Here we are checking this condition. And this condition is satisfied. Now we are avoiding second object. We are avoiding second object. And then it will go for calling this function. So this function is called by this case, right? Then this function is calling now, then it will check once again that one. So here we are including X3 object, then it will continue now. The same way it will continue and it will continue. We are getting now 17 plus 13 is true. So it will print the content. After printing the content, then it will return back. Return back to here, right? Printing the content, it will return back to here and it will print return back to here, right? Then it will return back to here and then here it will continue now. So once again, we are calling that function with here. Then we are avoiding X3. Then we have to go for this location. Then from here, so we are call, we are checking now. This is not possible. Then it will go for, it is not possible. We go for that B. Then here it will continue now, that one. So here now it will go for here to continue. So here we are having X plus X1. It will check that one. This condition is not satisfied. Then it will return back. It will come to here. This is not possible. Then it will return back. So here R2 return, R2 return, R2 return, then R1 return. It will come to here. Then from here to, then we are avoiding first object. Then we will continue now. then you are selecting second object, then we are continuing now. So here we is not possible using branch, it will go to X3 avoid, then using here it will come to here using branch B, right? Using branch B means this condition is not satisfied, then it will go to B. Now it will check that one, so it is avoiding that object, then it will continue. So now this is, now this is check, now you are using branch, it will go to X3 equal to 0. Now it will check, now using branch B it will go to X4 check now, and it will continue, right? Here there is no further possibility now, so it will return back R2 return, then it will go to R1 return. R1 return means in that location. Now it will check that one we are avoiding, the next object we are avoiding now, then it will go to here. So we are calling this function with this one, right? So here, from here to now, we'll continue now, the same process is repeating now. So here X1, we are selecting that the X3 object, and we'll come to check that one. So here X4 object is not possible, so we are using B. Then here we are come to here, then X4 this object is not possible, then using B it will go to here, and X5 also is not possible, then it is avoiding, then it will go to here B. Then now X3 is, we can include, so we can include X6. So X6, if you are including 12 plus 18, now we are getting, now 12 plus 18 we are getting now this object, right? So now this is the way of getting that result, right? So the result is 1, so x2 x1 1 x2 1 and x5 1. So here we are getting the result is 1 1 0 0 1, the last one is 0. This is one answer. Next answer is x1 1 x2 0 x3 1 x4 1, then we are getting now result, then all others are 0, right? Like we are getting now 3 answers, right? We are getting now 3 answers now, right? Clear? Okay, now you see, properly you go through that one. Here this is the algorithm. So that algorithm, I make it as a flow chart. For easy understanding purpose, I write it in the flow chart, right? Flow chart is, in the flow chart we are checking one condition, here we are checking another condition, here we are checking another conditions, right? Now that one is, I am going to use that one, right? Here this is the case, right? So here you include that also. After printing, now it will go to the return. So we have to draw one line actually. After print, then it will go to that return location. So you draw one line from here to, you join with that one, right? So here to, we have to, after printing, actually here it will come to here, right? After printing, where it will come now? After printing, now you see this one, this is the print. After print, now what will happen here? It will come to here. So you draw one line in that place, right? So here, you, after print, you draw a line to R1, right? So here you draw one line. I forget that one, or I not understand that one. Now I am understanding now, this one is connecting with this one, right? So after printing, then it will come to this checking, right? So now you see this one, first one x1 equal to 1, and we are checking now s plus wk is equal to m. So first checking, now if it is yes, then it will, we are getting one result, so it will print that one, right? Here next checking is here, right? So if swk plus swk plus 1 is less than or equal to m, why, what it is actually, whether this is possible for further exploring or not, right? If it's not possible, then no need to explore. So that what, here we are bypassing this one, right? So bypassing this one means bypassing this call. So this is actually, so we, here this is no possibility for getting result if you are selecting x3 equal to 1. x3 equal to 1 won't produce any result. So we cut out the branch. So we are going to have that one to B, right? So here we are checking this condition, right? So here current yes. Then we are using the next object. Next to next object we are adding. Now this is less than or equal to M. If this condition is satisfied, then we are exploring. Otherwise, then we are exploring means we are continuing the next left side object. Or otherwise, we have to bypass the left side object. Then we have to go for right side object. So we have to go for right side objects. So in that manner, we have to go, right? So here, first one we are selecting here, first one we are going to have that one. So first you are starting with this one, and then we are calling with that one, then we are calling with that one. So here now, here we are checking that this condition, this here we are having checking this condition, this condition is not satisfied, then it will follow that branch, right? Branch means actually we are bypassing this call. So bypassing this call means this branches are not valid. So not valid means it's not getting result. So we have to go for next x3 equal to 0, right? So now how x3 equal to 0? So this condition is satisfied. Now we are getting, now this is result. So here the after b we are checking this condition. What is the condition? So the remaining object may produce our result or not, right? Remaining object, and after avoiding the next object, if you are including, whether it may be less than or equal to m. So this two condition is enough for further exploring. Now we are exploring that one. So this condition is satisfied. Now it will use that c branch. So in that c branch we are putting that x3 equal to 0, and we have to continue, right? Similarly here this x4 equal to 1 is not possible because of this condition is not satisfied, then it will use branch b, then it will go to here x4 is 0, right? So now we are, this condition is satisfied, then this condition is satisfied at this location, then we are using that branch c. Now this condition is satisfied, yes, then it will go for x4 equal to 0, and we have to continue call this function with this one, right? So if you are calling the function with this location, whenever we are return, it return back to here. So it will continue return, right? So here now R1 is return, then we are using that branch D. So this condition is not satisfied, it will return to that one and return back by R2, return by R2. Now we are return back to previous call. Previous call is here. While calling this one, we are using this call. So this where we have to return R1 return. So R1 return means now it will continue that one for x2 equal to 0, right? Now in that location, we are checking this condition. This condition is true. So x2 equal to 0, and we are calling that function with this one is calling by this one, right? So this one is calling with this one, and then we have to go for this calling this one. Now we have to x3 equal to 0. So here x3 equal to 0. Now we are checking the condition. The condition is true. So it will come to here. Now we are calling that function with the x3 including. So this node calling this function here, right? Now here it will call that one. Next object if you are adding, then it is getting result here, right? Result here. So it will print the result. After printing result, we are returning. We are returning back to R1. Returning back to R1. And in this in turn returning back to R1, right? So this returning back to R1. Now it will continue now this one, right? So in that manner, it will go for that one. So as like that tower of Kanai problem, this also here we are going to have return back and return back. So we are getting now proper result. Clear?